Coral reefs. Coral reefs. Focus question. What are coral reefs and why are they being protected? Introduction. Earth's tropical oceans contain places of wonder and beauty known as coral reefs. These huge undersea communities are home to thousands of living things. Day and night, animals hunt, eat, and avoid being eaten. They depend on each other for food, shelter, and safety. Almost one-fourth of all ocean plants and animals live around coral reefs. Fish, sea turtles, sea stars, and many other animals make reefs their home. Visitors include seabirds and dolphins. What is coral? At first glance, coral may look like oddly shaped rocks and plants. Corals are actually tiny animals called polyps. Polyps. Most polyps are smaller than a pea. One branch or mound of coral can have thousands of polyps. Each polyp has a tube-like body and a mouth with tiny tentacles. Polyps are eating machines. At night, they open their tentacles to catch tiny animals. Hundreds of kinds of corals live in the ocean. Most are one of two kinds. Hard corals, also known as stony corals, from hard skeletons. Over time, many millions of their hard skeletons build up and form reefs. Most stony corals live together in algae. Algae are simple cousins of plants. They supply food for the corals and for many reef fish. Soft corals can bend with the current. They often look like trees, rushes, or other plants. Algae live in the bodies of some, but not all, soft corals. A busy underwater community. Most people think of brightly colored fish when they think about coral reefs, and with good reason. Thousands of kinds of fish live on reefs. Some reefs provide them with food. Reefs also protect them from animals that hunt them for food. Shrimps, lobsters, and crabs also find food at reefs. Sea stars catch small animals that hide among the coral branches. Sea animals, which look like flowers, wait for their next meal to drift past. Coral reefs support thousands of kinds of living things. They are important in other ways too. Reefs help protect coasts from storms and floods. By keeping soil in place, they protect coasts from erosion. Coral reefs also feed and shelter animals that provide much of the world's seafood. They help many countries bring in money and have food to eat. Also, reef plants and animals are used in machines, medicines from coral reefs. Scientists have made medicines from living things on coral reefs, and more are likely on the way. Corals produce a substance that is used to the treatment of asthma and arthritis. Medicines that treat several different kinds of cancer come from coral reefs too. Scientists are also studying reefs animals for ways to treat infections and skin problems. Where are coral reefs? Some reefs are close to shore in warm tropical waters. They also form where warm currents follow from the tropicals, such as in Florida. Coral grows best in warm water that is between 21 and 29 degrees Celsius. Since algae need sunlight to make food, most corals live near the water's surface. There are three kinds of coral reefs. Fringing reefs are close to shore. They usually follow the natural shoreline or fring of the land. Barrier reefs have a large, deep area of water between them and the shore. The world's largest barrier reef is the Great Barrier Reef in Australia. It is 2,300 kilometers long. The Great Barrier Reef is made of over 3,000 separate reefs and islands. It is home to nearly 2,000 kinds of fish. Atolls, the third type of reef, are shaped like circles. They form around the outside of an old sinking island or island volcano. Over time, the island sinks or the volcano breaks apart. Then a small body of water called the lagoon forms in the center. Dangerous to coral reefs. Coral reefs are fragile, and many things can damage them. Large, powerful, tsunami waves can break reefs. Most damage is caused by people, however. Many scientists think the pollution is partly to blame for coral disease. These diseases can wipe out the coral reef in weeks. Warmer ocean water due to global warming also plays a part. Global warming is a rise in the average temperature of Earth's air and oceans large enough to change long-term weather patterns, including clearing land for farming and burning coal, oil, and gas. These things make large amounts of carbon dioxide gas. This gas enters the air around Earth and traps heat close to Earth's surface. Global warming is causing many problems, including more bad storms and dangers to natural communities. Scientists accept the problems to get worse unless we cut way back on the activities that make so much carbon dioxide. Another problem, known as bleaching, also results from ocean water getting too warm. When this happens, the algae in coral polyps change in the way that harms the polyps. To stay safe, polyps get rid of the algae. Since the algae are their main source of food, they begin to starve. They also lose their color, which makes them look bleached. Corals can sometimes recover from bleaching. But if the cause of bleaching continues, both the corals and reefs will die. Bleaching now affects 3/4 of coral reefs because of human activities. Earth's oceans also contain too much carbon dioxide. The extra carbon dioxide makes ocean water more acidic. As a result, corals can't take in a certain chemical that keeps their skeletons healthy. Without it, their skeletons dissolve. People are harming coral reefs in another way too. Fishing methods that are poisoned and explosives have destroyed over half the reefs in the Philippines. Building along coasts causes soil erosion and pollution. Another dangerous breaking of chunks of coral reefs by accident or unproposed. Protecting coral reefs. Many countries have taken steps to protect nearby reefs. In some places, it is against the law to take fish, plants, or coral. People and boats are not allowed near many fragile reefs, but these laws are only a start. Coral nurseries. Scientists grow pieces of healthy coral in nurseries. The pieces may be rescued from boats damaged or coastal building projects. Scientists hang the pieces from bars or place them in baskets. Later, they move the pieces to damaged reefs. The pieces help the reef become healthy again. Half of the world's coral reefs have been destroyed. Most of those that remain are in trouble. Scientists are working to help coral reefs. They can help too. We can help too. Even if we don't live near an ocean, we can do our part to reduce global warming. Using less energy, recycling, and walking or biking will all help. With our help, coral reefs will be a beautiful natural wonder many years from now. What can you do to help?